Now to that rocket launch that ended in a massive fireball, the $200 million mission up in flames and raising questions about the future of space travel for both the government and private citizens. ABC's David Curley is on Wallops Island, Virginia with more. Good morning, David.
Good morning, Robin. No answers about what caused that massive rocket explosion, but it emphasizes questions about the commercial effort to carry cargo to space, questions raised by a NASA advisory panel earlier this year.
And we have liftoff of Antares.
It was just 11 seconds after liftoff that the rocket started breaking apart, falling back to Earth, exploding in a large fireball. A $200 million loss, and millions more in damage to one of the few launch pads in the U.S., raising questions about the country's move from government-funded space travel to commercial companies taking us into space.
Are you guys up to the task?
No, this isn't necessarily a comment on commercialization. This is a comment on rocketry. And launching rockets is a high-energy endeavor.
A risky business, but that hasn't stopped some high-profile CEOs from reaching for the stars. Virgin Galactic's Richard Branson wants to carry people into space.
I can't wait for our first day of commercial operations here.
He signed up some of the biggest names in Hollywood to be future space flyers. Ashton Kutcher, Katy Perry, Russell Brand, Kate Winslet, Leonardo DiCaprio, even Brangelina all have tickets to ride. But this morning, are they rethinking riding a rocket?
Anytime you're dealing with high energy, you're dealing with high risk.
That NASA advisory panel advised back in January that insufficient funding of NASA oversight of the commercial effort to get cargo to space risks failure. Robin?
All right, David, thank you.